Hey guys, so today I want to talk about the Canon EOS M100 and why I think this camera is actually the best deal right now that you can get in 2020 for creating content on YouTube. So I was able to get the Canon M100 with the kit lens, which is the 15-45mm, along with a telephoto lens, which is the 55-200 for the price of $399. For the price of $399, that's not just a great deal. This is a steal, guys. This is an amazing bargain for a camera that's basically the same quality as the Canon M50 for a much lower price. Now, the price of the telephoto lens itself, the EFM 55-200, retails for about $250. So basically I got a $250 telephoto lens included in this bundle, which only cost me $399. Now the Canon M100 is not the latest model. There is a Canon M200, which recently came out. It does have a newer processor, which allows you to shoot in 4K. The Canon M100 does not allow you to shoot 4K. But like the Canon M50, the 4K shooting is really handicapped. You get 1.6 times crop, which really zooms in. Plus the autofocus for 4K shooting is just bad. It's terrible. I would consider the Canon M50 a 1080p camera. The 4K would basically be non-existent to me. So although the Canon M100 was launched in 2017, I still think it's a great camera, a great deal for you to buy in 2020 for many reasons. So the reason why I got rid of the Canon M50 was because I really wasn't comfortable with the form factor and the size of the Canon M50. It does have a flip out screen, but it flips out to the side. I really feel like when you flip something out to the side, it really increases the footprint of the device. The Canon M100 has a flip up screen, which I feel like doesn't take up as much real estate. For vlogging, I think the flip up screen is better because if you were to ever glance up at the screen, I think it's not as obvious as if you were glancing out to the side to check your shot. Also with the flip side screen, because it's taken up more space, I feel like it's just not as convenient to use. For me, I really favor the portability, compactability of the Canon M100 versus the Canon M50. It's smaller, it's lighter. I think for me, the only downside would be that it doesn't have a mic input. It doesn't have a cold shoe mount for you to attach an external microphone. But honestly, I think with just like run and gun vlogging or just the type of videos I wanna make right now, having the Canon M100 is the perfect device. Video quality is exceptional, it's superb. It's got the DIGIC 7 generation processor, which has 49 point autofocus system. It has a dual pixel autofocus that's really famous in Canon. It's superb. So basically as I move around, it's gonna continue to keep tracking. So the specs of the Canon EOS M100, sensor is an APS-C size, which you find in all the Canon mirrorless cameras, except for the newest Canon M6 Mark II. It's 24.2 megapixels. Again, I mentioned it has the 49 point autofocus system. It's got a 3-inch tilting touchscreen, which flips up. Shoots full HD 1080p up to 60 frames per second. So the downsides, no viewfinder, no 4K video, but for just your typical YouTube content right now, I think 1080p is fine. And so that's enough talking. I'm actually really excited to unbox this. So let's go ahead and do the unboxing and take a look. We got some literature manual, and we have the Canon strap. We have an included charger and battery. This is the same battery that's used in the Canon EOS M50. It's the LPE12. So luckily I already have some spare batteries. Same battery, Here we have the camera body. We'll set that aside. And here we have the 15 to 45 lens. So this one would be the telephoto lens. Let me unpack these out of the wrap. So here's the 55 to 200 millimeter telephoto lens. Image stabilized. Next is the 15 to 45. This is the standard kit lens that comes with most of the Canon mirrorless cameras. Same lens that came with the M50. After unboxing, we'll see how this looks on the Canon M100. All right, so now let's take a look at the camera body itself. So here it is. The Canon EOS M100. Again, very small form factor, fits in the palm of my hand. And I like that the design of it is basically like a small digital camera or a point and shoot camera. It does also have a flip up screen, as I was saying before, for when you're vlogging. I feel like having a flip up screen actually is better than having a flip out screen that flips, you know, this way. Just kind of gets in the way of when you're doing things. You have the universal screw mount, so you can put a tripod on or a Joby Gorilla Pod for when you're vlogging. So this right here, honestly, 2020, best budget camera you can get right now for a beginning YouTuber. Right here on the side, you have some ports. You get the proprietary Canon port to attach to your computer. You can also upload your images to your phone or computer wirelessly through Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. It's also NFC enabled, so you can easily and quickly transfer files and videos. And there's also HDMI, so if you wanted to use this for webcam streaming, live streaming, you can also do that with this camera. Here we have the SD card slot. So here we have the SD card slot, which will go right in there, which I think it's great because if you did have a tripod down here and it was, or some sort of mount or plate, you don't have to unnecessarily unscrew it to take the SD card out. This is where the battery goes in, at the bottom here. There is no USB charging. Which is one downside. I would like to have USB charging or in-camera charging, but the replacement or extra batteries are relatively cheap. You can keep those charged up and you can just pop them in, which actually is better for when you're shooting on the go. Instead of waiting for the camera to charge, you just pop in another battery. So that's not a big downside to this camera. There is no microphone jack on this camera, and there's no mounts up here at the top. So let's pop the battery in. Hopefully there is a charge on the battery and we can get the camera up and running without having to charge it right away. And let's just take a quick look. I'll throw on the kit lens, the 15 to 45 millimeters, and see how the footage looks. If you are a new YouTuber like myself and you are starting out making videos, creating content, and you don't want to spend a fortune, I think maybe you should really consider this camera. For the deal that I got, brand new, again, brand new, not used, not refurbished, brand new M100 with the 15-45 millimeter lens plus the telephoto lens. That's a great deal. All right, so I have it on, let's power it up. Okay, so it needs to charge. I fortunately have spare batteries, so we'll pop in one of those so we can power it on. So I got these spare batteries off of Amazon. They were relatively cheap. Brand is BM Premium, dual bay USB digital charger for your batteries here. So you get two of them, they're fully charged, and they're good to go. And because this is a USB charger, I can connect this to a portable power bank and actually charge these up on the go. So let's open up the battery slot here. Battery goes in there. Powering on. So let me get this all set up. I'll set the date, time, everything. Now with the 15 to 45 millimeter lens, it does collapse down for portability, which I do like as well. And to use it, you just kind of flip this toggle here. You extend the lens out until you hear the click, and then you're good to go. So actually right now I'm filming on the Canon M100. This is the camera that I bought for my fiance. I had the audio settings on manual. I don't know how it sounded or how it turned out. I just switched it over to auto, and I'm gonna do the rest of the video with this on auto. We'll see how the audio sounds. So as you can see here, see if it can show itself. So I've been shooting this whole video with the Canon M100. All right, so I'm gonna throw the SD card into this camera, and we're gonna do a little more shooting. And we'll just do a little quick vlog test. We'll record a little bit. We'll see how the quality of this looks. All right, so we're all set up. Now you're looking at each other. Don't mind that. I don't have a tripod, so I'm using our Mixap study books to prop the camera up. It's actually a perfect height. So first thing I wanna talk about for vlogging is the tripod that you would use. This is technically a Joby GorillaPod. It's not as big and robust as the ones that you see all these vloggers using, like Casey Neistat. This was actually designed for a GoPro or the DJI Osmo Action. As you can see here, the mount is actually for the GoPro mount. What I have attached is the screw mount, and this allows me to just screw right onto the camera here. And because this camera is so light, it's basically the same. Well, maybe it's a little heavier than the GoPro, but because it is so light, I can actually use this without, you know, without the Joby GorillaPod being all bent out of shape. So as you can see here, I'm using the Joby GorillaPod. I'm using the 15 millimeter lens right now. This is actually not super wide, but it's actually not too bad for vlogging. So hopefully the audio sounds pretty good on this as well. And of course with the Joby GorillaPod, you can also spread the legs out like this and contort it to any shape that you want. So you can just set it up for regular vlogging, or you can attach it to weird, you know, angles for some shots. I don't know. Whatever you want to do. See if that'll hold. Yeah, so that's holding. So for example, with the Joby GorillaPod, you can mount it to basically anything, and you'll get some cool shots that way. My favorite vlogging tripod is actually the Ulanzi. Let's see if I get that focused. Ulanzi MT8, and this is what it looks like. And I'll show you why I like this so much. This honestly is the tripod selfie stick that everyone should be using for vlogging. This is why I like it so much. So you have this knob here that you can loosen, and that allows you to change the angle. So if you're doing like vlogging this way, angle it towards you, just quickly tighten it. And here's the best part is you can extend it just like this, and that gives you that nice arm's length. You can have it as far or as close as you want it. But also when you set this up, let me just show you here. So when you set this down, you don't have to worry about the legs bending and the unevenness like you have with the Joby Gorilla Pod. Oftentimes with the Joby Gorilla Pod, when you place it down, it's really not level. And the best part is, like for this shot now, I'm really not in frame, but what I can do is just extend it up like this, and now I am in frame, now I'm in the shot. And all I had to do was just extend the tripod pole up. And I haven't had any issues with any sort of lenses causing it to be off balance where it'll tip over, or the tripod legs getting loose. I think with the Joby Gorilla Pod, you'll see some of the videos where it'll slowly start to like dip down like this, because the legs just can't support some of the cameras. So I'm gonna go with the Ulanzi MT8 mini extension pole tripod. I think this is the best selfie stick or tripod that people should be using. Let's take this outside and we'll do a little vlog test with the Canon M100.